Inquisitor.
Scout Harding.
We're on the outskirts of Sarnia. This is what's left of the town. The lucky ones got out before the river froze over. The rest, penned in by Fade Rifts and Red Templars. We're the first friendly face they've seen in a long, long while.
The Red Templars in the area will need to be destroyed.
Knew we could count on you. The Red Templars have been mounting frequent attacks. They want Emprise de Lyon. Bad. Let's get out there and take it back from them.
Hello everyone and welcome to Set 15, let's play Dragon Age Inquisition, my rogue playthrough. This set is going to be dedicated to Emprise de Lyon. Now it's a great place to go to, especially with a lot of high level enemies. This is one of the last couple of areas you'll actually visit in the game, just due to the fact of how high level the monsters are. Now, the main quest here is something I've already done, mainly because it would have taken forever for me to do a record on screen. Plus, I had some stuff I needed to get that was here. Anywho, the main quest was to actually make our way up to where we are right now, and fighting Red Templars along the way, then clearing out Sildan Keep. Now, Sildan's Keep is actually pretty big in and of itself, so I figured this would be a good enough part to use for the set, but since I know it's not going to be long enough, we'll be fighting a dragon afterwards. Now, the dragons in this area, there are three of, and all of which are very difficult. Two of which are frost dragons, one's a fire dragon, so prepare ahead of time. Now, there's also a trophy we can get here for fighting, I believe it's this dragon, with the Rub Some Dirt on It perk active. Or the Rub Some Dirt on It trophy trial active. This basically makes it all your healing potions only heal one potion, or one health. So, it's kind of annoying. Excuse me. However, each of these three dragons guards something you'll want to gain access to. This dragon up here guards a silverite mine. You just get a shit ton of silverite there. That's where I get most of my Fae Touch silverite after I beat the dragon anyway. This one is guarding an ocularium, so you can't gain access to the Ocularium quest, or finish, I should say, without finishing this quest first. And lastly, this one's guarding the last landmark. Kind of annoying. But we'll be getting to this dragon later on. Now, there is a quest down over here as well. What's this? Shrine, right. There's a quest down over here which involves freeing a bunch of slaves from Red Templars. They are people who are forced to mine Red Lyrium, unsafely, by the way, by the Red Templars, who came from the village up over here. Now, if you finish this bottom quest, you gain the ability to set out your guards to take the mayor of the town and judge them. Now, I already have this bottom quest done, and I already have the judgment for this character already recorded, so look for that in the judgment video. Anywho, let's get to it and clear out this keep. Now, I have not gone back to Skyhold since the last set. So, yeah, I mean, actually. Nah, we're fine. The dragon's probably going to be really easy to kill, all things considered, considering this is my my rogue, who is designed to basically kill people quickly. FYI, if you want to play a character that will kill enemies quickly, don't play a warrior or a mage. Play an assassin rogue. That marked for death ability, if you do it just right, will kill everyone. No ifs, ands, or buts. They're dead. It's awesome. Hey, buddy. Aim and hello. Come on. There we go. Nope. You got the kitty shield. And knock knock. Like always, all the keeps, like I said before, have that special sad splinters you can get for destroying them, so make sure you grab them. If you're going for that joke weapon, of course. You don't need it. And it literally sucks, so no point in getting it really. And fire! I don't want my voice cracked. But fuck you. Backflip! Fuck you, Red Templar, bitch! I love this. So I'm also going to be editing a video in the near future. It's a new discussion video. We'll talk about that real quickly. It is on the Ruby series released by Rooster Teeth. It's basically going to be us here at Santa Familia talking about the Ruby series from the trailers all the way up to the new season. Talking about basically our favorite battles and shit like that. As well as talking about the our views for what's going to happen in the future. It's going to be a prelude to a series me and Cthulhu are going to start, where we will review Ruby videos as they come out. So yeah, hope you guys are looking forward to that. I'm looking forward to it. I love Ruby. If you haven't seen it yet, go watch it. Just all you have to do to look it up is type in Rooster Teeth. That's rooster as in the bird, and teeth as in the things inside your face. And Ruby, spelled R-W-B-Y, is spelled that way because the four letters are an anagram for the four main characters of the series, Ruby, Weiss, Blake, and Yang. It's a great animated series, I recommend seeing it. If you are a fan of Dead Fantasy, created by Monty Ohm, rest in peace, you'll love Ruby because it is his own personal pet project that he has been working on for years, but did not have the funding to be able to make. But thanks to his job, the job he had over at Rooster Teeth, he was able to convince Matt and Bernie, the owners, as far as I can tell, of Rooster Teeth, to let him make it. So, yeah, it's freaking awesome. It has more story than Dead Fantasy does too, as well, by the way. It's not all fight scenes. Although, there are a good many of those. Nope. Enough gushing on Ruby. Let's kill some giants! Hello! Backflip! Get him. Goddamn! Woo! That was close. Nope. Snipe. Shield. Another attack incoming. Sorry, bitch. Right, cut my dagger. My bow. Get poisoned. Alright. There we go. Hit him. There we go. Goddamn. Alright, let's get to you. Come on. Nope. Out of the way of that. Fuck. Keep forgetting how squishy I am. Come on. Shoot. Yeah, snipe! There we go. Alright, where's Thana? There she is. You cannot kill us! I've killed more than all of you. Shut the fuck up. Alright, there we go. Ah, Caltrops. Nice. Ah, so far so good. The bottle up over here we need to grab. I know, Varric, I know. Calm down. Calm your hairy tits. Here we go. Nope. Alright, another bottles of the wall. Balls on the wall. Bottles of Thetis. I believe there's a trophy associated collecting them all, or at least a certain percentage. Alright, we're going to stick to the right-hand wall as much as we can, so we can avoid some red Templars and a giant. Don't want to go through that again. This way. There's some Philanderous down there, by the way, in case you need it. This place is rich in Philanderous. Holy shit. If you're looking to get Philanderers for poisons or other stuff, other such stuff, this is a beautiful place to get it. Holy shit. And boop! Backhead! Get him. Shield. Sorry, bitch. There we go, that's big AoE. Backflip. Now, let's get rid of this ass at, because I'm getting hit by him. Or the archer behind, or the archer behind him, at least. God damn, what's with my health dropping all of a sudden? Nope! Hell to you, bloody heathen. Back the fuck off! Nope! Ain't legit me! Hell with that. Oh, damn, come on. Almost there. There we go. I flip. Come on, Thana, you can do this. It's almost there. Aim and up the skirt. Wunderbar. That was easy enough. Alright, open this door. Let's continue on our way. Boop. Alright, I got some more toys in here. Headshot. Fuck you. Aim and fire! Ha! Gotcha! Have to be careful though, there are a few, shadows around here, as well as a behemoth. I think a shadow almost tried to get me. Yeah, there's a shadow. I see you. Sorry, you ain't getting me. Boop! Gotcha. If I can't hit you with one arrow, I'll hit you with 20. Kinda how it goes with an archer build, you know? You're either going to hit them with your first arrow and take them down, wound them, or you're going to do a backflip and kill them all with a big AoE. Fire! There we go. Simplicity in itself, in of itself. Okay, not ready for this. There is normally a supply crate here, but obviously there isn't. So fuck. Now let's go. Let's see how I pull this off.
Who are you?
Call me Imshale.
You're a demon.
Ahem. Choice spirit.
Talky ones. I hate the talky ones.
Wait! These are your friends? They're very violent. It's worrying. True to my name, I will show you that you have a choice. It doesn't always have to end in blood.
No, you die, demon.
Spirit.
So, to be fair, I'm unsure if he is a spirit or a demon, but I will give you a little bit of backstory about Imshale here. Imshale, whatever. Ishmael. That's what I'm going to call him. I know it's not his name, I'm going to call him that. There were three legendary demons back in the old time. They were known as the Forgotten Ones, or the Old Ones. They were the ones that taught blood magic to humans and whatnot. According to the Chantry or history, shit like that. Technically, we've met two of the three. In, well, actually, I think we met three of them. Huh. I know for the fact, in Origins, you can meet one of them. He's in a side quest involved in Denner. I did a quest involving him during that set, so, yeah. This is the second one, obviously. But they're all very high-powered demons. They're very deadly. And they generally all take multiple form battles, so... Luckily, this elite is a bit of a pushover elite. Immunity to fear, sleep, and frozen. He does have a spirit vulnerability and electricity vulnerability. Not bad. Okay, then... Let's go! Don't use that yet. Well, I want to, but I don't want to. You know? Okay, where's he at? Mark for death! Go! When he gets HP below a certain point, he will, transform. Oh, shit! Knocks HP to zero with that one. But, didn't count, unfortunately. I have to go through the forms. Excuse me. Drink! Back off! So he goes through a fear demon, a rage demon, and then a pride demon. So we have to be careful. And naturally his stats change depending on what form he's in. Like now he has a cold vulnerability, fire resistance. And he's thundered right now, so yeah. Like I said though, fortunately Ishmael is not that bad if you know what you're doing. Basically just stay back with away his HP, you'll be fine. Let's wait for his transformations. Way to go, Solas! I was gonna switch you to do that, but hey, never mind. Fuck off. Ow. Hey, guess what, buddy? I have the high ground. Which means I get a bonus. I love having the bonus for the high ground perk. Boop. Nope. I'm out of heal potions. Fuck. Woo! That was close. Fortunately, he pretty much focuses on you as well. So if you do it right, you can just have him run after you while your party whittles away at him. Ow. Rude. Aim and fire! Dick! Yeah, it's coming after me now. Fuck! Alright, we gotta go wake up, Bull. Get up, Bull! Get up, Bull! Back out of the way! Fuck onto him. There we go. Alright, he's almost dead. I do like the fact, though, that he is a spirit of choice. But because of the way he does things, people classify him as a demon. Ow! Nope. Let's go over to, these guys. Backflip! Get him! Got him! Good!
How could you possibly be a spy?
Nah.
Well, it's a pretty easy job. I do some fighting, drinking, and then once in a while I tell Parvolin about it.
Where's the sneaking, the plotting, the subtle machinations?
If you do that, everyone knows you're a spy. Drinking, fighting, writing notes. That's all it really takes.
Shit. You're either the worst Kunari ever or the best.
That's the point! Now give me this. Pure red lyrium. Ooh. What'd you drop me, mate? Pure spirit essence. March of the Everlasting. An amulet of renewal. So, you can buy this if you choose not to go with him, by the way. If you choose to, accept his terms, though, he will probably give you, either an upgrade to your stats or a superb rune of corruption, which is 50 damage to anything that's living. Yeah, buddy.
Is he gone? The demon is finally gone.
Delirium has taken hold. He doesn't have long.
Donna has very little patience for people like you. So there's a trophy for doing this quest as well, for this area as well. If you go through here, the entire thing, with the Travel Light perk, which is where you can, where you have no healing potions, you get the trophy after you clear out this place. I did that with Lucifer, so hooray! Excuse me. You'll get the trophy right here, by the way. Not during the cutscene or when you claim it. Which is kind of annoying, because I got a little worried, like, eh? Did I fuck up somewhere? Give me this. Alright. Now, if I got them all, there's only 7 left. Which I get for clearing out the, dragon after we kill, I get for, the Oculator after I kill the dragon. That's requisition. Fuck. Go around. Let's do a quick save and let's go hunt ourselves a dragon. So we want to go for this one first. Now, the sets after this will have the other dragons in them, but not ones that have dragons already in them. Like, for example, the next set's going to be a storyline, so no dragon. After that is the Hissing Waste, which already has a dragon. Then the Forbidden Wastes, which is going to have the second Empress du Lion dragon. And then set 20 will include the final dragon as well. So, yeah, a lot of stuff. I will be doing the end game boss fight before finishing up all the stuff here. The Cradle of Sylvan. Hold on. The Cradle of Sylvan and the Lost Temple of Dithermin are all going to be into one lump at the end of the Let's Play, after I beat the final boss of the main story. Then after that, it's going to be Trespasser. So basically, the Let's Play is going to follow as this. The next set, where we're going to go after Cripheus in the Hidden Area, in the Elven Ruins. The Hissing Wastes, plus the dragon there. The Hissing Waste will just be a, probably an air short set like this one. After that is going to be the Forbidden Oasis, and the second Empress du Lion dragon. Again, that's going to be another short set like this. The endgame boss for set 19. Set 20 is going to be the Cradle of Sylvan, with the Lost Temple of Dithermin, and the last Empress du Lion dragon. And then set 21 will be... Where the hell am I going? Will be the Trespasser DLC. So that's pretty much the next couple of weeks for this game. Up there. So shit. We're at set 15, so 5-6 weeks. Hooray. 6 more weeks. Shit. That's a month. Oh, a little more than a month.
one of the artifacts of my people.
It's right there. You have to fall off the edge to get it, though. Alright, let's do this. Like I said, this is a help. This is a frost dragon, so have the frost dragon ability with it, or your ice protection at least. And this guy is a bit of a beast. No promises. So yeah. Kelterjan here, how you pronounce that name? Bit of a beast. It's probably an elite version too. Bit more of a beast when you're a dwarf, because fuck. About the size of one with freaking talons. Luckily his defense is shit. Are you an elite? You're an elite. Okay. Fuck you! Alright, zoom in. Get the health down pretty damn quickly. Like I said, it's gonna be a pretty easy fight. Now, my shields are protected, and we wait. This dragon also has the ability to summon little pissants to attack you with, so be prepared. I'm going to use my Mark for Death when it lands, followed by my circle. A backflip. Keep it close. Boop. Alright, get rid of that shield. I killed a dragon god version of you. You are nothing. Come on. Shoot! In the face! The one thing I love about being a dwarf, by the way, you're so small, when they do that tail swoop thing, you pretty much are right out of the way. If they pretty much can't hit you with it. Don't get me wrong, they can, but good luck doing it. Alright, we should be good. Nope. I once threw a stone fist at this dragon, this specific dragon. And it actually trailed around and followed him. It was hilarious to watch. There we go. That took a good chunk of itself out. God help me if I had my focus here, right here, right now. I would destroy you. Alright, let's get rid of the dragon so they're not as annoying. You backflip. Die already, bitch. There we go. Whoop. Nope. I would use my Mark for Death, but it's almost dead, so it's gonna do that. Or it's almost at that point, so it's gonna fly away. I love when he does his little ice blast thing behind one of those ruins. It just hits it and just like, okay, sure. You wasted a dragon breath. Good for you. Straight for Varric. Come on, bitch. Probably should heal you. Alright, here we go, last time. Marked. Hit. Backflip. Boom. Killed him. Whew. Oh, shit. Alright, let's loot the Dragon Corps. We get the Caliban, which is the original name of Excalibur before it was rechristened into the Excalibur, I believe anyway. That or it's the Sheep. I've heard legends say both, so. Either way, very good sword. Very powerful. Extra potions. This is great if you are in this mode without the ability to go and get the extra stuff. But you have to make sure to stop by a potion stand and fill them up. Because this +3 is after fast travel, so you'll always have 12 if you have the max, the perk for the more potions thing. So if you want the extra 3, you have to make the 3, which is really annoying, but understandable. Pearl, Masterwork Prowler, and then a bunch of dragon parts. Hooray! So that's it for this set. I hope you guys enjoyed Empress du Lion. It's a beautiful, beautiful wasteland, or snowland. We'll be back here a few more times to kill the remaining dragons over there. And over there. But till then, have a wonderful day. Goodbye.
Hello, and thank you for watching my Dragon Age Let's Play. If you'd like to see the other playthroughs, feel free to click any of the annotations below. Hope you guys have a wonderful day. Bye.